9 months ago, I was hanging out in Zeller's basement, and we were just talking about expedition ideas, and he brought up his trip to Greenland. And even though it was like a pixelated, tiny little photo, I knew that it was insane. As soon as I saw that, I just hit the research, finding anything I could about Greenland, about this Kuraly Glacier area north of Kulusuk.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other thing, not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that goal will serve to organize and measure the best of our energies and skills. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win.
Essentially, in snowboarding, there's a few mountains around the country you can get good at, and Mount Baker up in Washington is one of the mountains that some of the best snowboarders have come out of. Luke has grown up with all these other guys who are older than him, paving the way. Luke just became good fast.
I didn't know Lucas in his like full punk snowboard kind of craze stage when he was younger, but somewhere along the way his passion has shifted, and it still involves snowboarding, but now he's like so obsessed with the whole like cult that is mountaineering basically.
Lucas is the next generation of snowboarders that are gonna push it into the mountains, I think.
Coming into this season, knowing that Greenland is going to be the pinnacle of my winter, it's all about getting your legs under you, getting mentally and physically tuned up for an environment that's completely unknown and conditions that may be completely variable. I met Johnny about 3 or 4 years ago and was immediately drawn to his entire persona. Johnny, with everything he learned in his first trip to Greenland, will be extremely valuable for this next expedition.
Coming to a place like this, you know, you have amazing pow, you know, 100-foot pill lines, some spine lines, you can catch lots of air, it's very freestyly. It's just fun, it's sick, it's like snowboarding to the core.
Thank you.
this kind of experience, like coming out here in midwinter, snow camping, riding pillow lines, it's really involved, but the reward is just unreal. You wake up and you're standing on top of the sickest run of your life.
There's a lot of variables coming into this pillow line. So if you get out of control at all, which it'll be super easy to do, there's not a whole lot of room for error at the bottom.
First thing I saw when I flew in here a few days ago, and it's been on my mind ever since, but it's pretty intimidating.
So remember, it's just mellow.
Yeah.
How's it going? That is a bucking bronco.
Doing out here is pretty dangerous. When you see someone as experienced and knowledgeable as Lucas go down like that, it makes you think twice about what you're doing.
All I can think is, you know, this might be the last turns I made this whole season. And that's a pretty harsh reality to deal with. It wasn't until the x-rays came back and they said that I didn't have any fractures to my spine. At that point, I knew that I could be able to go to Greenland.
The path we have chosen for the present is full of hazards, as all paths are. But it is the one most consistent with our character and courage as a nation, and our commitments around the world. And one path we shall never choose, and that is the path of surrender.
Holy shit. The boat we took up to this town is full, like 50 sled dogs, where all of our gear was.
The hardest part of this whole mission is like we need to get up higher so it's colder and we're not in the rain, but to get there, we just can't sit around as our weather window diminishes waiting for a dry day.
Always an adventure. Welcome to Greenland.
I think any time that you push yourself out of your comfort zone, the dynamics of the group is one of the most important aspects of an expedition. And working with Johnny, Hillary, and Ralph truly was that like prime group of people.
From the recent rain, it's caused the snowpack to get super wet, and everything's kind of peeling out in wet slides.
Pack ice is really thin on the edge, so right now we're just taking hit after hit at the pack ice, trying to get the boat into more solid territory.
I grew up on a boat where you avoid shit in the water, you don't aim for it.
Here we go.
I'm like so jaded sometimes when I go on trips, because I'm always like, oh, I'm never going to see anything new or different anymore. But wow, I mean, just this day alone. How do you guys feel about walking on this stuff?
Yes. Somebody let the fucking dogs out.
Did you let the dogs out?
I didn't. They were fucking ready to go. The dogs are ready.
I had no idea what we were getting into, and I hope we find some snow.
There's some of the ice, and pretty much sank, you know, 3 feet into the water, so I don't know where we just went.
Checked in, we're a little bit farther up the pack ice towards the toe of the glacier. Avalanche is coming down from either side on both aspects into the valley, and the ocean's coming up from beneath us.
Wow.
Everything's just melting down. We got huge avalanches like that one right there.
Definitely snowed up high, and it's all, with this little bit of sun, it's all just crashing down on us, so we're kind of in a shooting gallery right now, which is a little unnerving.
We made it to the toe of the glacier after like 10 hours of dog sled mayhem, and everyone's pretty fried, I think. To the hut. I'll tell you what, it feels really good to be here right now.
I thought we were gonna be sleeping down in the wet, gooey fjord tonight, basically. So the fact that we're up here is pleasantly surprising, to say the least.
Ralph sent me into his bag to find my puppy jacket, and I just got iced in Greenland on a glacier. He hauled this shit all the way up here so that I could do this.
Yes! Oh, that's great. Nice.
Wow. Very good.
The terrain's unbelievable, but unfortunately the snow is quite the opposite. It's like being in a candy shop, but all the candy's poisonous.
What if it wasn't the photo?
It's just a big out-of-focus peak. It's even more intimidating.
Finally got our first view at the Peak of Inspiration. Now we're staring it right in the face, and it is one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen.
As we got onto the glacier, the fog rolled in. And then all of a sudden we were in frickin' pea soup and you couldn't see more than 50 feet.
Hear the wind blowing on the tent. There's just not much we can do.
Well, despite the fact that temperatures today are far higher than they've been for some considerable time in many parts of the country, we're certainly not out of the woods yet.
We have no reference as to where anything is, so hopefully we can find our way back.
I think it's sunny, so all these guys can go ski while I dry out in the tent.
Mother Nature to me. She's always the one in control, and I always feel like it's kind of a test, like a personal test.
We just kept coming up the ridgeline there, and we sort of popped out above the fog layer. Pretty sick. Remember what it's like to be in the sun amongst the big mountains.
Fog had definitely done a number on all of us. The peak we wanted to get to was just too far away. It was better to kind of explore with a more consistent base camp.
There was no powder left. It was just frozen solid. It was boilerplate. We just made the best of it.
We've been here for 2 weeks and this is our first sunny day. To see the entire range is absurd.
Johnny and I ended up climbing this pretty insane line. Probably was 1,000 vertical. The second you cross the bergschrund at the bottom, it was a no-fall situation. The top section was probably 60 degrees, just wallowing through this crust and sugar snow, really insecure.
Everything there was way steeper than it looks, what Johnny was skiing down. I mean, it was crazy, crazy steep.
ski in a line like that, you have to be super careful. Being that deep in Greenland, if you fall, there isn't really any help. So you have to take all that into consideration and make the whole face a no-fall zone.
Really like pushing my own limits, but when it comes to you fall, you die situations, I don't exactly excel. Based on the conditions, I just decided it wasn't for me and ended up going down the backside on an easier route. And as much as that kills me and still burns the hole right now, I do think it was the right decision. Forget one percentile, like 0.0001% of humans will ever get to witness this amazing isolated mountain range. When you put days, weeks of effort into riding a couple great lines, you remember them for the rest of your life.
I have therefore chosen this time and place to discuss a topic on which ignorance too often abounds. And that is the most important topic on Earth. Peace. I am talking about genuine peace, the kind of peace that makes life on Earth worth living. Not merely peace in our time, but peace in all time.